Now, for most of his political career, Jeremy Corbyn has been the lone outsider, the backbencher on Labour's wilder fringes, the token left-wing no-hope challenger for the Labour leadership, the politician who never even in his own wildest dreams thought he could be Prime Minister. No longer. Now he's flavour of the month, far beyond his traditional left-wing base, with approval ratings that have overtaken Theresa May, leading a party that is currently favourite to win a snap election, and headlining Glastonbury. Prospective parents are even considering naming their babies after him. Don't know whether it's Jeremy or Jezza or even Corbyn could become a new Christian name. You could be forgiven for forgetting that Labour actually lost its third general election in a row, with fewer seats and a smaller vote share than the Tories. But Jeremy Corbyn has momentum, with a small M and a capital M. Can it carry him all the way to Downing Street? Here's Adam Klug from Momentum, with a big M, in a big bowl, showing us some momentum with a small M.
A little under 2 years ago, I helped to establish Momentum. We played a key role in the extraordinary election result for the Labour Party. Using innovative technology and viral social media content, we mobilised tens of thousands of people to knock on millions of doors across the country. It's now time for parts of the media that have demonised Momentum to recognise that Jeremy Corbyn's vision for Labour, which we support, is popular across the country. It's only Theresa May that needs to worry about Momentum. She's leading an unstable Tory government propped up by the anti-abortion, anti-gay rights, climate change denying DUP. Another general election could come soon, and Momentum has already launched our campaign. But if we're to win, Labour needs to stick with the bold, transformational vision for a society that works in the interests of the many. It's not about chasing the mythical medium voter, but setting out a sustainable, investment-led economy that people can actually believe in. We must make sure the whole party unites around Jeremy's leadership, working together. We've rightly seen many of his doubters in the parliamentary party throwing their weight behind him. So we need to stay united and build on our transformational manifesto. With the Labour Party led by its members inspiring tens of thousands of people to get out on the doorstep, that is how we'll win! Mass membership is a strength. Gone are the days of experts in suits calling the shots in Westminster. Rather than being locked out, members should be empowered to lead the party. Those tens of thousands of members who took the time and energy to canvass across the country, they're the key. They're how we'll transform Britain for the many, not the few.
And thanks to Quadrenaline Quad Biking Centre in Milton Keynes. You won't get me there, but Adam Klug is here. He swapped his inflatable bubble for our less fast-moving Westminster bubble. Welcome. Liz, if there was a snap election between now and late autumn, would Jeremy Corbyn be the next Prime Minister?
I think he could well be. Things have changed a huge amount over the last 3 or 4 months. But, you know, we've still got to win 65 more seats to form a majority. That's just a majority of one. We've got to double the swing at the next election than we got at the last. And I think the challenge for us is to kind of deepen the support of the people who came to us a couple of weeks ago and broaden that out too. And that is going to be tough. I think that we've done extremely well amongst university educated people, women, those under 44. We still have a problem with older voters and many people in our so-called traditional working class areas. And I think the great unknowable is, can we both hold on and deepen the support of those who've come to us whilst reassuring those who've had concerns without losing some of the kind of enthusiasm that we've seen at the general election? And that's the great unknown.
How's he going to do that?
Well, I mean, I agree with Liz that there's still a way to go, but it's a tremendous achievement from polling at 24% just 7 weeks before the election was called to over 40% of the popular vote.
But how does he get the next 60 seats to give him a majority of one?
Well, I think we saw a big, bold vision for the country in the manifesto, which proved to be popular for a lot of people. But what we need to do now is mobilise that mass party that much more, bring that many more people into politics.
Do you need to widen the appeal further?
Well, I think it's clear that this manifesto has been really popular.
But you lost. So what do you have to change to win?
I think it's about communicating the vision of the manifesto.
So it's a communications issue rather than a substance issue.
I think we saw during the election that when Jeremy got more of a fair hearing and when the policy platform was articulated effectively and we were able to mobilise tens of thousands of activists to knock on millions of doors during the election, that a lot of people really bought into that vision and believed that it would create a better society for them.
What explains the Corbyn phenomenon?
An extraordinarily bad Conservative manifesto. A Prime Minister went through the election refusing to debate, while Jeremy Corbyn appeared as a genuine individual who got more of a hearing than he had done before.
But it has to be more than just the Tory campaign and manifesto being useless, because there are other parties to vote for. But actually, in England, about 85% of people voted either Tory or Labour. They did go to Labour.
Yeah, but what I've just said remains the most plausible explanation, because it wasn't only that the Labour Party was polling at 24%. You might say, well, the polls were wrong. It was also that Labour were completely crushed in the local elections, which were only about a month before the general election. So there was an absolutely seismic change in public opinion and public voting. And the best explanation of that is the Conservative manifesto.
You say, Liz, that Mr Corbyn has to broaden his appeal to get these other 60 seats. But he hasn't even reached out to your part of the party, to Labour Centre or centre-right. He said, come on board on my terms. That's what he's done.
I wouldn't have expected him to, but look, the many, many conversations I had with people who have voted Labour for a long time but were worried about supporting us, they wanted reassurance on defence, security, our approach to terrorism. They wanted to know that we really could afford to pay for all of the things that we were saying.
And were they reassured by all that?
I think many of them stuck with us, partly because, not just because the manifesto was bad, but because the Tory manifesto was bad, but
right,
of arrogance. But also, can I say, I think we have tapped into this sense that even Philip Hammond has admitted that people have seen after 10 years, they've seen cuts to their public services, but we still have a huge deficit to pay.
No, I understand. Let's not relitigate the election like this.
That is part of what we tapped into.
What I'm trying to work out...
Were you reassured on defence and security and terrorism?
I was glad that Jeremy Corbyn said after the Manchester attacks that the police should use all necessary powers to deal with them. I think we have
quite,
to go further
quite
on
controversial.
That. I think we have... Well, exactly, that shouldn't
who,
be controversial.
Who else would not say that?
But and we also had a commitment to multilateral, not unilateral disarmament.
You're not really answering the question. The question is, Liz, how does he broaden out if he's not even reaching out to people like your side of the party?
Because I think we have to give reassurance on security and that we can afford to pay for the things.
No, that's not... Well, I'll give up, because it's not what I'm asking
you. But surely...
No, I want to bring Adam back in.
All
he's
right,
our
indeed.
Guest.
Adam's our guest.
I understand why you're enthusiastic, why you see the opportunities, and they've said that he could be the next Prime Minister for a quick election. There is also, on the other side, a danger that this could be as good as it gets. I mean, we live in a world now where the political cycle moves so quickly. One day you're cock of the walk, next day you're a feather duster. Just ask Mrs. May, or even Nicola Sturgeon to some extent as well. Maybe you do need a snap election, or this moment passes you by.
Well, I think there will be an election soon, because I think this coalition of chaos is what it will be. And with the DUP propping them up, and we saw yesterday with the public sector pay cap that the Tories are in disarray, whereas I actually think this is the beginning with Labour, and that, for example, Momentum, our social media content went viral. One in three Facebook users in the UK saw one of our videos. We knocked on, as I say, millions of doors, but that was just the beginning. We're training people up. We've got Bernie Sanders volunteers coming over, helping people have face-to-face conversations on the doorstep.
So you're building?
We're building, and we launched our general election campaign yesterday.
Because you're in permanent election campaign, I understand that. Does something like this, Kendall, have a future in the Labour Party?
Sure, of course. I mean, the Labour Party has always been a broad church. And,
but does she have to buy in? Does she have to come on board now to the Corbyn project?
Well, what we saw with the manifesto is that when the whole party united, there was real support for that manifesto and it really worked. And when there wasn't infighting and division, we really moved forward effectively. And I think we need to carry on building on that, and we need to get that many more Labour MPs into government when that next election happens.
Sounds like a death sentence to me.
Well, you know, listen, I found... You didn't let me say this the last time I was on, Michael, so I can have a chance to say
it. Well, let's do it.
You know, in my constituency, people really... Of course, there are always some people who are, you know, there's difficulties, but the vast majority of members pull together. We've got different views, different approaches, but we're a democratic party. And we're all, you know, we all want the same goal. Some of us have different ways of getting there, but I think we showed that when we work together, you know, we have a great result.
But your way's going nowhere, is it? Your way's going nowhere. Even if Mr. Corbyn was to fall under the proverbial bus, his wing of the party will remain in control for the foreseeable future. You and your side of the party are now being written out of the script.
Well, listen, he's not going anywhere.
No, I said if he falls under the proverbial bus,
let's hope he doesn't.
It's not about sides of the party. I think what we're seeing is a new political culture and a new wave of politics and how different people are getting involved, people from a diverse range of backgrounds, and we're changing that sort of Westminster bubble.
But how do you maintain, and I use the word carefully, the momentum? If, as is possible, I mean, I understand what you say, there could well be an election. We don't know, it could be at any time. That's the uncertainty. But if Mrs. May manages to stumble on for the next 18 months, and that is also possible, how do you maintain the momentum?
I mean, it's hard to imagine that will be the case, but if we're going to constantly be going to marginal constituencies, and there's new marginals now, where places which previously Tories had big leads are now much closer, and we're going to be having those conversations with people, so we'll stay in that zone, but also we'll be communicating those ideas effectively and trying to bring new people into politics.
Do you fight the next election, in your view, on the same manifesto or a more radical manifesto?
Well, I think this manifesto proved very, very popular. Lots of the policies in it are popular, and it sets out a vision for the country.
So do you just keep that for the next election?
Well, I think at the moment that's very popular, yeah. I think that's where we're going. That manifesto, fantastic.
The Tories do need to stumble on, don't they? If the Tories don't stumble on, Adam Klug will be proved right.
No, I entirely agree. I mean, I think a snap election at the moment would be very, very bad for the Tories, partly because of the deal with the DUP, partly because of the terrible fire in the Tower block, which I think has gone very badly for the government, partly because of the momentum that is there at the moment, partly because of Glastonbury. For all those reasons, this would be a terrible moment. But we've seen in the past that minority governments can stumble on for quite a long time. Labour government in the past stumbled on for 5 years with no majority. So let's see how we go.
We shall indeed. Adam, we'll have you back at some stage, see how it's going. Thank you for being with us.
Cheers, everybody. Thanks.